Right now, we got to win this conference game to be in the state playoffs. But certainly to the people of Casper and the students of both schools, you know, there's a lot of school pride and, you know, what area of town you live on, pride in that, and those type of things. So it's important to our community.
A bunch of spirit, that's what it's mainly about. It's a bunch of spirit. And K-Dub's right now beating us, but as you can see, we're trying our hardest.
Are just incredibly excited, and all year long they look forward to Renaissance Fair. They really enjoy hands-on activities, and because they're being held more accountable every year for what their specialty area is, they go out, they go to the library, they research it, and then they have to use their oral communication skills and demonstrate it.
For several years, there have been reports that the American schools haven't been doing well on the international scene in terms of math and science. And quite honestly, I have to agree with what I've seen just with my own children, that we probably are behind. I don't know that there's any one easy answer. It's not simply a matter of money or teachers or supplies. I think it's a lot of things need to come together. And I think one area we can start is by recognizing those students who do well in school and elevating them to kind of a super student status, if you will. So this is kind of a little more of an individual way to recognize students like that. And hopefully we can kind of make it take the nerd image away from working hard on your grades.
I can't say enough about Steve and the job he did preparing these kids for this game. I mean, they played their hearts out here and really laid it on the line. It was just one heck of a football game.
You know, we just got one at 4th and 6, 3 minutes. We get the first down, you know, we're on the way. But, hey, that's football. It's a good high school football game. We came up a little short, but you're right. I'm proud of our guys' effort. We played with a lot of heart today. And, hey, what more can we ask? They played hard for us. Yep.
Gibson is the defending girls individual medalist, and she won that last year at Cody, so I'm sure she'll be happy to return there. Mm-hmm. And Kelly Sullivan is a two-time all-conference player, has never played in the fall. She's been playing volleyball.
But, you know, hopefully by the end of the year, they'll improve their skills and intensity level, and we hope to, you know, finish in the top half of the state tournament.
Thank you. to the mind, both be engineers.
Engineers.
I like numbers.
Yes, numbers are great.
Numbers are good. 1 + 1 = 3, right?
Exactly.
All right, there's Andy. Excuse me.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to announce the salutatorian for the class of 1992. Please welcome Angie Hall.
Friends, family, distinguished guests, welcome to the Natrona County High School class of 1992 graduation. This momentous occasion is primarily a symbol of transition. It sends a vast array of emotions running through each individual as he or she passes through high school into the future. We graduates are now responsible for the decisions made in creating our new image as mature adults. Graduating, perhaps, can be a bittersweet experience because of the difficulty of this decision period. We all want to command our lives and control our destinies. But the perplexities of life often bewilder us as we face our choices. I believe that we have the mental strength to learn from our errors. We must never allow our mistakes to hinder us, but instead we should utilize them as one more learning opportunity. In my mind, this ceremony also denotes the ability for each graduate to become successful in any chosen pursuit. Though I realize I may experience setbacks, I am still confident and eager to step into the unknown and create a fulfilling life. I know there's much knowledge out there and waiting for us to discover that, and much knowledge out there for us to discover, that none of us should ourselves fear to hold ourselves back. As I look back, I am deeply touched and appreciative of the abundant efforts of my teachers at Natrona and what they have given me. As I go forward, I will carry fond memories of them always. Each and every one of us have special people throughout our high school years that we wish to thank. Mine include my parents, substitute parents, and also my dearest friends, for they are the ones who have supported me as I've strived to achieve my dreams. I urge you all to look hopefully and enthusiastically into the future, for you can accomplish whatever your dreams desire. Marcus Aurelius said, "The universe is changed. Our life is what our thoughts make it." Go into the world boldly and leave your mark. Good luck, class of 1992.
It's my pleasure to announce this time the valedictorian for the class of 1992, Mr. Ryan Gish.
As we are all gathered here for the culmination of our high school years, I'd like to talk about all the memories that we've made together. At this moment, words seem so inadequate and incomplete. As we've grown up together through the good times and the bad, the joy and the sorrow, the pleasure and the pain, we are able to behold the tremendous impact that we've had on each other's lives. As I look out over you, my fellow classmates, I am able only to imagine the immense amount of opportunities that we will encounter. As time's winged chariot carries us further away from our high school years, just remember, wherever you go, there you are. As we meet future challenges and reminisce over our tender memories of youth, we must bear in mind that we are driven by the present. But we must also look to the future, for the future holds so much success for us, the class of 1992. And this success will be a true testament to the excellent education that the faculty has bestowed upon us. We are, mark my words, the best class to ever graduate from NCHS in 1992. Every one of us sitting here is ranked in the top 100% of our class. This is truly an accomplishment. I'm not just kidding. We need not be disheartened at this, our commencement, for the word is derived from its initial meaning as a fresh beginning. It is at this time, the inauguration of our adult lives, that we must look forward to the horizon in search of all our dreams. We must hold on tight to our goals and convictions, unless a little voice in the back of your head says, "Let go, my hands are tired." It is inevitable that we will all drift apart, but we must realize that all the roads lead back to home, unless you find yourself on a one-way dead-end street. If this happens, just sit there, remain calm, relax, and wait for another car. We must cherish the remaining time we have with our families, for they will not be forgotten, but our everyday dependency on them will be removed. We must consistently find time to write and call them for money. Speaking of my parents, they're having a huge party for us after graduation. No, please hold your applause. You're all invited. There's going to be a DJ and a band and dancing. And I think we'll have a little gambling. So why don't we all meet over at the rec center in about 2 or 3 hours. Don't knock, just go ahead and let yourself in. I almost forgot. I was going to talk about all the memories that we've made together, but these are such individual memories, inexpressible memories, that we will always hold close to our hearts. So seniors, I will leave you with this. We are out of here.
I'd like to take this time to congratulate you, the class of 1992. I decided I wanted to give something back to everything that has been given to me this year, and the only way I thought I could do that was to write a song. When I first began to write this song, I was thinking of all the excitement and all the joys that we were going to experience once we graduated. Then as it got closer and closer, I began to experience a little bit of fright and a little bit of scared. So I decided to combine them all and write this song just for you. So I dedicate this to you, the class of 1992.
Friends, he will. It's my pleasure to be here and to be a part of the 95th graduation commencement exercises for NCHS High School. This is my second year in Natrona County, and I'm proud to be a part of a great institution such as NCHS, and I'm very proud of the accomplishments of the young people that stand before us tonight. My first responsibility is to introduce the graduation commencement speaker this evening. I don't know any better way to begin this commencement exercise than to have before us a man that has not only been a successful doctor, but I think most importantly, he's been a successful father that nurtured his children as far as they could go. I'd like to present to the NCH class tonight the valedictorian of the class of 1944, Dr. Joseph Murphy.
I think it says Nuncius Pilato in the program. Now you know what a Nuncius Pilato is. I wasn't sure. You can put that many kids through college when you charge the exorbitant fees that I did in my medical practice all those many years. I see here a note ahead of me, one brief note, a little housekeeping to do. I am told we have 10 people with us tonight, seated in section S. S is right up there, who drove all the way here from Johnny Carson's hometown in Norfolk, Nebraska. Well, I have to tell them we do appreciate their coming, yet I regret to have to tell them this is not the Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. It is rather the first tomorrow show of the graduates of the class of 1992. Mr. Zollinger, can you hear out there? Yeah, golly, the number of people here tonight, I think this is amazing. I tell the graduates, I've been here for other graduations, as you will learn, and this is as nice a crowd as I've ever seen. Mr. Moore, members of the school board, Ryan and Angie, you did a fine job, as did our musicians. Graduates of Natrona County High School, in this grand and glorious year of 1992. Your parents, your families, your friends. I am, as I told you earlier today, honored to be your commencement speaker. Reed and I join you tonight, as has been mentioned, as fellow graduates of NCHS, as was Rita's mother, Marie Gerber, class of 1923, and each one of our 12 children. So for if no other reason than sheer numbers, I think it's an arguable point that we should be with you tonight to celebrate this joyous event. One member of our family very badly wanted to be here tonight, but she gave birth to a child 2 weeks ago and felt that this was a little premature to do any traveling with the child. But she insisted that I mention it, so I want you to know that my daughter, Murphy Brown, sends you her very best regards. I'm having things thrown at me already. I've just got started. Come on. Now, as you may have read, and I think you'll find this interesting, the graduation at Notre Dame was a blockbuster. President George Bush was the graduation speaker, and he championed family values. My goodness, after what Mr. Zollinger said about me tonight, I have to champion family values. So I was all with the president on that, as I would suspect most of you are. Well, I tape recorded the president's speech with full intent to play it back to you tonight as my offering to you, saving me the problem of writing anything for this speech. That would have freed me up over the weekend to go hang gliding off of Lookout Point on Casper Mountain. But that didn't seem fair, so I thought that I had to put together at least a few words to show you how I feel about you, the school from whence you come, the community where you live, and the wonderful people that support you here tonight. Now, Sarah McGrath was the class valedictorian at Notre Dame. In her speech, Sarah split the audience right down the middle. You did a beautiful job, Ryan, but at least you had everyone on your side. Sarah did not have everyone on her side. She took President Bush and literally took him apart. You may have seen it on national TV. Now, she spoke much truth, but it's not the thing to do to bring a guest into your parlor and kick him in the teeth, and that's literally what Sarah did. So as I was listening to Sarah, I was thinking of Ray Bradbury, the famed science fiction writer, who has the following quote, and it's inherent in everything I say to you tonight. If we listen to our intellect, we'll never have a love affair. If we listen to our intellect, we'll never have a friendship, and that is ridiculous. So you've got to jump off cliffs and build your wings on the way down. Jump off cliffs and build your wings on the way down. Now, that's a grand idea, and I think Sarah McGrath at Notre Dame must have read the same quote, because she sure in hell jumped off a cliff. And I think she's still building her wings on the way down, and I'm going to check back and see if she ever landed safely. But she gave me the thought, and I can see parents in the audience tonight saying, oh my golly, there's Joe Murphy, local radical up there again, telling our kids to jump off cliffs. Well, please don't take me literally. Battered bottoms and broken bones aren't my message to you tonight. But in the life, in this life, we all must take chances. Because if we don't take chances, we go nowhere. We must at least try. So I think you will find the brief message I'm going to give you is one of hope, optimism, and courage. What is Mr. Bradbury saying to us? Well, he's saying first, we must care. We must care. Now, my Notre Dame classmate, Dr. Tom Dooley, he cared for the people of Southeast Asia, and he changed that part of the world. Tracy True, your student body president, she cares. In your right yearbook, she writes, Tracy writes, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. And to care was a prime message of Christ. Mr. Bradbury says we must dare. 2 weeks ago, Dorothy Clinch of Omaha, age 77, jumped out of a plane 10,000 feet above the earth. Assume she had a parachute, but at 77, she's jumping out of airplanes. Rob Wheelow, if you followed the news, NCHS class of 1971, he dared, and yesterday he ran in the Boulder Marathon. There were 37,000 runners. Your fellow NCH graduate finished first, absolutely first. Mr. Bradbury says, do your own thing and do it in style. Now, Pete Williams, class of 1971, became the spokesman for our nation during the Gulf War. In eloquent prose, Pete kept us appraised of what was going on. And I tell you, graduates, knowing that you, in many ways, wanted Pete Williams here, I, too, regret that he was unable to be here tonight. Pete would make an immensely good commencement speaker, and I have nothing but love and praise for Pete, another one of your NCH graduates. Soon to be a graduate of NCHS is a member of your class, Tad True. Tad and I have been close in recent weeks in that I've had something to do, I hope, with perhaps recruiting him to be a freshman student at Notre Dame next year. That's a good time for the clap. In the Mustang, Tad writes, curiosity will not cause us to die. Lack of it will. Then Tad says, be a cat. Don't know entirely what you mean, Tad, but be a cat. I like the idea. I'm sure it implies that you be curious, you be daring, and you be caring. As Angie pointed out, love your family. This is where it all starts. No one loves you more than your mother, your father, your brothers and sisters. It may not seem this way at times. Hey, we've had some Donnybrooks in our home. But when it comes down to how much your family loves you, take my word, bet on it. Make new friends. keep the friends you have. Do you realize the pool of friends that you have right out on the arena floor here tonight? Many people in the course of history have commented that some of your very best friends are the friends you made in your youth as you were growing up. As fine a friend as I have in life tonight is Gene Benning, NCHS class of 44. We get together every possible chance we can. You may only keep one, two, three friends. If you keep three, you've done very well from this graduating class. But these friendships are lasting friendships. Nourish them. Write letters to your friends. I know we're in the age of AT&T. Telephone does everything now. You don't have to write. But write a letter. Write a note, if only a note once in a while. Don't ignore the written word. Your friend needs it. They need to feel it, to caress it, to fold it, to put it away, to look at another time, to remind them of your friendship. And the one third thing I would suggest to you that I have suggested before audiences in this city is hug, H-U-G, hug. Writer and counselor Virginia Satir says, we need 4 hugs a day to survive. 8 hugs a day for maintenance, and 12 hugs a day to prosper. I wonder how many of us here tonight go to bed about a dozen hugs short each day. Leo Buscaglia, noted author, lecturer, and teacher, said, the loving person must return to spontaneity, to holding each other, to thinking of each other, and to caring about each other. Hugs are good. A, they feel nice. And if you don't believe it, try it. Well, let's finish. In 1984, I stood before the NCHS graduating class. I asked them 3 questions, and I would ask you the same 3 questions tonight. Do you realize just how much it means to your parents to tell them that you love them? It's a message we parents must hear, and we must hear it often. We must hear it in joyous times such as graduations and celebrations such as tonight, but we need to hear it in sad times as well. Tell them in the quiet of each day and in the silence of each night, but tell them. When did you last thank a teacher for investing a lifetime of love in your education? You are their very reason for being. You can sustain them oftentimes when the going is terribly tough. Individuals in the educational field now are undergoing a tremendous life change. Early burnout, student rebellion, the entire thing. Tell your teacher. Pick out 1 or 2 teachers that you had at NC. Visit them when you come home. Let them know. Write them a note and thank them. It's the least any of us can do for people who give us as much as they do. And the third question I asked the graduates in 84 was, when did you tell your best friend that he or she was your best friend? One of my friends here in town, Barry Horn, came by the other day to work on my computer, and he turned to me and he just simply looked at me and he says, Joe, you are my best friend. Hey, I thought about that for a long time. Tell your friend that he or she is your best friend. William Thackeray, the English novelist, said, we are, most of us, lonely in this world. And believe me, that is true. The adults in the audience today will tell you that loneliness is much more a part of the human condition than mirth and gladness and being in the crowd. William Thackeray said, you who have any who love you, cling to them and thank God for them. Well, my questions are simple questions, and my answers are simple answers. Yet the world you graduate into now may well rise or fall on matters of no more consequence than these. Elemental things, but terribly important things. And I would think that's what President Bush was driving at when he spoke at Notre Dame about family values. Do these 3 things. care a lot, love a lot, and show it, no matter how high the cliff from which you jump, no matter how rapid your descent, you will grow wings. I guarantee it. And these wings will carry you to a soft and safe landing. Last page. Young men and women, our children, our friends, our future. We, your parents, your families and friends, congratulate you. Yes, we do. This is not that blasé an accomplishment that you have before you tonight. We are very proud of you. We pray your world is full of happiness and joy and fulfillment. Life can be, and most often is, great, great fun. Jump off a cliff, and on your way down, grow your wings. You are somebody. You are special. Never settle for less. Now, go in peace. Hug many friends tonight, the last blast, wherever you go. And then live a lifetime of love. We do love you. And now let's get on with the show.
Thank you, Dr. Murphy, for those eloquent words. We'll remember them always. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
And now we'll hear from Leland McConaughey, Wind Beneath My Wings. Thank you.
I would like to dedicate this song to all of the parents in the audience. In the last 18 years, you have given us so much, and you truly are the wind beneath our wings. Behind, I
Thank you, Leela, for those beautiful words. Distinguished guests, friends, and relatives, the class of 1992, it has been our special privilege to work with the members of this class for the last 3 years. During this time, they have sought knowledge and gained understanding. They have learned a valuable lesson in their sophomore year when they learned how to share a school with their fellow students across town at Kelly Walsh High School. During the last 3 years, they have experienced the joys and frustrations of becoming an adult. They have experienced the thrill of victory and the sense of accomplishment and the disappointment of defeat. Throughout their time at Natrona County High School, they have worked hard to develop their talents and to master their lessons. They have maintained their sense of humor and their sense of purpose. In fact, I probably should tell you tonight that we ran out of honor stools for this class because there were so many good students. We had to have them air expressed here to get them on time for this event tonight. They have earned the respect and the admiration of our faculty and staff. And so it is with pride in their excellence that we say congratulations on a job well done. And now, Mrs. Catchpool and members of the Board of Trustees, as principal of Natrona County High School, I hereby certify that these students assembled here before us have satisfied all requirements for graduation, and I recommend them to receive their diplomas at this time. Mrs. Catchpool?
Thank you, Mr. Moore. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I'm proud to accept the class of 1992 for graduation from our school district. You are the class who, as sophomores, opened your arms and your doors to your crosstown rivals and let them enter your school and show this community that in spite of competition and when the going got tough, you were there to make it work. And for that, I personally extend a thank you to each one of you. It ended up being a good year for everyone, and you guys showed the community that you could do it. I've been at your talent of... You're right, it was a great year. I've been at your talent shows, your Mr. Mustang. I've been at your concerts. I've watched you achieve academically. I've watched you achieve in competition in sports, music, drama. You've been outstanding. Our community and our school is better because you have been here. And so now I say to you, go into the world, have a great life. Remember, hug, share, and you're out of here. Congratulations.
Valedictorian Ryan Scott Gish. Salutatorian Angela Michelle Hall. Student Body President Tracy Lynn True. Senior Class President Dennis Eugene Ellis. William Grant Allen. Jennifer Lynn Sir. Richard Anderson. Joe Allen Anderson. Tara Lynn Anderson. Julie Ruth Badger. Charles Justin Baldwin. James Clark Barragear. Julie Ann Barnett. Jennifer Dawn Bates. Brenton Arthur Baugh. Robert Edward Bowers. Robert Ray Bedsall III. Patrick Gordon Bagley. Joan Frosty Bentley. Brian Ted Burtnell.
Anne Michelle Cluel. Marcella T. Cisneros. Amy Catherine Chenoweth. Trevor Allen Cecchettini. Onita Marie Carter. Cody K. Phillips. Amberlee Erica Camp. Marty Daryl Codwalder. Marie Louise Byrne. J. Brendan Bummer. Scott Raymond Budig. Lori Lee Buckner. Nicole Annette Buck. Cassandra Lynn Brush. Lisa Marie Box. Michelle Lee Bowens. Jeremy Wade Carlisle. Rodney Cooper Biggs. Ryan Lee Burtz. Shane Cameron Burtonall.
Nicholas Andrew Hopkins. Tammy Lynn Farmer. Kelly Sullivan. David Michael Graham. Michael Terry Kistler. Jeffrey Paul Bechtel.